Hi guys, today I'd like to show you how you can use Browserify instead of sprockets in your Rails app. I'm using this approach in production quite successfully. Why would you do that? Well, JavaScript and front-end in general become more complex, and I think that standard Rails package doesn't meet modern requirements. Moreover, sprockets make your JavaScript code very specific to Rails, thus onboarding of new developer could be problematic. Let's look at our app. I use my demo React app that I've been changed to make it work with sprockets. Let's run. This is just a simple spreadsheet app with rows and columns in which you can type numbers, and it also implements simple formulas. As you can see here, we use sprockets to describe dependencies. The only external dependency I have is underscore, and it's in vendor directory. Well, let's start rewriting our app. First, let's add Browserify Rails gem. Let's open its documentation. We need package.json in order to use npm for dependency management. Let's copy and paste it into our app. Documentation is a bit outdated. These modules have newer versions already. Let's use them. Okay, let's run npm install. Here we have our node modules directory. Whether you add this directory to gitignore or not, it's up to you. But remember left path, it's better to have it in your repo. Let's now configure Browserify. We are going to need two more packages to transform JSX, Babel preset React and Babelify, which is a wrapper for Babel for Browserify. Let's create an initializer for Browserify gem. This line tells Rails to reload if node modules changes. This line is just a way we pass additional parameters to Browserify, and here we tell that we want to use a Babel transformation with React preset. Let's now rewrite our modules in CommonJS style. As we have npm for dependency management, let's install modules that we use in our app. The modules are React, React.DonUpdate, React.DOM, and underscore. Now we need to rewrite our modules. Let's exchange sprockets with require. And of course, we have to explicitly specify exports. Let's remove JSX extension so React Rails won't process our modules. And let's delete the cache as well. Now we have to update application.js. Here we have jQuery, we have React and React UGS from React Rails gem, and all our components. With Browserify it should look a bit different. First of all, we don't want to have React twice, so let's delete this line. Second, our bundle should go before React UGS. Now let's create a new file for our bundle. Here we require React, React DOM, and an entry point to our app, spreadsheet component. React.js expects to have React and React DOM in the global namespace. By not specifying var keyword, we effectively bind these variables to window object in a browser. Let's run our app. For the first time, Browserify needs some time to compile everything. After that, Browserify incremental works much faster. Well, as you can see, everything works except of buttons. That's because we haven't rewritten our update function. We use React add-ons update, and previously it was bundled with React. Let's refresh our browser, and now everything works. As you can see, it wasn't that hard to migrate. Of course, this is a demo app, and it's going to be more complex on a bigger production app, but it's doable. Let's speak about the benefits. First, we get dependency management from NPM. Second, we get better tooling and IDE integration. And now we also can extract our frontend into a separate app and repo. You may think it's not a valid bonus, but when you work on a bigger app, it's really convenient to have a separate app. All links you can find down below. I'm going to make more videos on techniques I use in production, so please subscribe. I hope you liked the video. Thanks for watching. Bye!